situation is for every single member of our team of 5 million. But if we get our immediate response right in this critical phase, we have the opportunity to lessen the time that we will have those heavier restrictions. And that is a lesson that we have all learned together. So please, as always, stay kind, look after one another, and please stay tuned as we update you on the situation as it continues to unfold.
Well, let's talk right now to Jill Higgins, who's a reporter for TVNZ in Auckland. Morning to you. So what have people made of the fact that things really have had to change again, in Auckland particularly?
It's a huge disappointment, I think. It's the same kind of reaction as last time, even last night when the announcement at 9:15. I think by 25 past, people were already filling up the supermarkets and stockpiling goods like flour and pasta and toilet roll. So same kind of reaction, but this time just a little bit more down, a little bit more depressed about it, because it feels like we've been here before and we were really hoping that we wouldn't come again. And especially for businesses, they'd started to build up their customer base again. People were going on staycations in New Zealand, they were going out for meals, and now they've had to close their doors on those businesses again. And as you know, in the UK as well, it feels like you're being kicked when you're already down. So that's been odd.
And New Zealand has had an exceptional record, really, on coronavirus. Is there any indication how these cases, where they came from?
Not yet, and that's kind of the critical question. So at the moment, they've said a level 3 alert. So as you say, that's these places are closed, got work from home, schools are closed. And at the moment, they said that's for 3 days, so until midnight on Friday. They're saying what they want to do is identify that source. And if they can do that and they can block these chains of transmission by isolating all the people, then they'll re-look at whether we need to stay in alert level 3. But that's an ideal world, and as we know, 2020 isn't much of an ideal world, so it's very likely that they're not going to be able to identify all those chains of transmission. They may not even find the source by then, because there's no link to the border restrictions, there's no link to foreign travellers, so that's what they really need to work out. So it's really unexpected.
And all the 4 cases are in one particular family?
That's right. It's a family in South Auckland, a bigger family, so a family of 6. 4 of them tested positive for COVID. And if it was just sort of isolated to that family, it would be fine. But they'd had symptoms for quite a long time. They travelled to another town, Rotorua. They'd been to tourist attractions there. They had both been to work. So there's one refrigeration company, a finance company, about 300 colleagues involved overall in both of those workplaces. So as you can see, they've got a big job doing their contact tracing to try and lock this down.
And this also affects the whole country. There are particular restrictions in Auckland, but also others in the rest of the country as well.
Yeah, that's right. So Auckland is where they're at level 3, so that's the strictest lockdown conditions. Rest homes all over the country have been put into alert level 4, so that's complete lockdown. And as far as the rest of the country goes, it's alert level 2. So that could mean social distancing, just being more aware, wearing masks if you can, but not as much as the restrictions that are being placed in Auckland.
Good to speak to you. Thank you very much, Jill Higgins. Thank you.
Time now is 7:20. So with a day to go before students get their A-level results in England, the government has announced that they could use...